हेलो फ्रेंड्स एंड वेलकम टू मैकेनिस्टिक फार्माकोलॉजी वंस अगेन। फ्रेंड्स फ्रॉम टुडे ऑनवर्ड्स वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ स्पेशल लेक्चर सीरीज। दिस लेक्चर सीरीज इज बेस्ड अपॉन पीसीआई सिलेबस। सो द फर्स्ट लेक्चर सीरीज द कंटेंट इज कीमोथेरेपी ऑफ ट्यूबरक्लोसिस एंड दैट इज सोली बेस्ड अपॉन द पीसीआई सिलेबस। फ्रेंड्स इन दिस लेक्चर सीरीज there are total 6 lectures. So lecture number 1 is the pathophysiology of tuberculosis, which we are going to discuss right now. Lecture 2 is the pharmacology of isoniazid, then lecture 3 pharmacology of rifampicin, followed by lecture 4 pharmacology of ethambutol, then lecture 5 pharmacology of pyrazinamide and other antitubercular drugs. Friends, very importantly, lecture 6 is very very interesting. There we can learn the important exercise as far as the chemotherapy of tuberculosis is concerned, and along with we will take the multiple choice questions as far as GPAT is concerned, and along with multiple choice questions we have the reasoning answers that what the correct answers and what why the remaining answers are incorrect. So we have a very good discussion at the end of the lecture 5, that is the lecture number 6. So friends, stay tuned and stay connected, and let's begin with our first lecture, that is pathophysiology of tuberculosis. Hello friends, let's start with the introductory slide. What is tuberculosis? So friends, tuberculosis is one of the bacterial disease that causes growth of nodules. So these nodules, they are also called as tubercles, and the area which affect by these nodules is lungs. Friends, it is characterized by some inflammatory reactions due to one of the causative microorganism, and that is called as tuberculosis, which is a rod-shaped aerobic non-motile acid-fast bacillus. Interestingly friends, throughout the world, near about 1/3 of the population get affected by means of this disease that is called as tuberculosis. Now, if we talk about the history, now Robert Koch, a German physician, in the year 1882, isolate this species, and he received Nobel Prize in the area of physiology or medicine in the year 1905. Friends, there are some other strains of tuberculosis also. They are Mycobacterium canisasi, Mycobacterium marinum, Mycobacterium scrofulicium, Mycobacterium avium, as well as Mycobacterium intracellular. Now when we talk about all these species, now maximum over than 90% of the cases of tuberculosis occur due to the bacterium Mycobacterium tuberculosis. However, these species are remaining 10% of the species. Now, one more point, that Mycobacterium avium. Now, in India, near about 3.5 million of infected HIV patient get associated with the tuberculosis by means of this bacterium Mycobacterium avium. And this is report published by the WHO as well as ICMR. Finally friends, this Mycobacterium species transmitted through the inhalation of infected droplets, which can spread through air via cough, via sneezing, via talking, shouting or via laughing. Now heading towards the salient features of Mycobacterium. Now the cell wall is a very very important constituent of the Mycobacterium tuberculosis. Now here the lipid rich mycobacterial cell wall is impermeable to many agents, which is made up of waxy coating. Friends, cell wall of this Mycobacterium is made up of a waxy coating on its cell surface, and that is called as mycolic acid, and a substantial portion are intracellular, residing within macrophages and therefore inaccessible to the antibiotics. So friends, due to its lipid rich content, maximum portion of this microorganism, it is it becomes intracellular. It resides inside the macrophages, which are one of the defense mechanism of our body, and this is the reason why they are inaccessible to the antibiotics. Doubling time, it is 24 hours. Now when we compare this doubling time with few species like E. coli, those have only a doubling time of 20 minutes. So here the doubling time here is approximately 24 hours. Now growth and replication, this is one of the very very important parameter that why this tuberculosis is one of the most difficult treated bacterial infection among all the infectious disorder. So what is the reason behind? Mycobacteria, they are slowly growing organism and they become dormant, they reside into the macrophages and they can survive in dry state also. Another reason, the speciality of URAC gene. Friends, we all know that phagocytosis when elicits, so it contains an enzyme that is called as lysozyme. Now this lysozyme at acidic pH, it can kill the foreign bodies or any infection which comes inside our body. So this acidification step is very very important as far as the killing of any microorganism is concerned. So here friends, Mycobacterium tuberculosis, it contains a very important gene, that is URAC gene, and that prevents acidification of phagosome. Means the lysozyme will not going to kill this mycobacterial species. Now another reason, Mycobacterium tuberculosis also contains diterpene isotuberculosinol, which prevents the maturation of phagosome. So due to these certain reasons, due to these salient features of Mycobacterium, such type of infection is really difficult to treat, and therefore a longer duration of therapy is required for the treatment of Mycobacterium tuberculosis. Now heading towards symptoms of tuberculosis. So symptoms are varied depending upon the type of exposure and type of microorganism. However, some common symptoms those are associated with the tuberculosis are low grade fever that occurs generally in evening, night sweats, malaise means the feeling of uneasiness or discomfort, then fatigue, weight loss and blood streaked productive cough. So these are few symptoms commonly observed into the tuberculosis patient. Now coming towards this diagnosis. Now as far as diagnosis of tuberculosis is concerned, it can be done by means of chest x-ray, TB skin test, sputum microscopy as well as culture test. So friends, goal of therapy. As we had discussed previously that due to the mycobacterial cell wall enriched with the mycolic acid, there is a inaccessible drugs which can penetrate towards this Mycobacterium tuberculosis, and therefore friends, single drug is not effective and therefore combination of drugs is required to prevent the emergence of resistance. Secondly, we had discussed some salient features of microorganism also, that these Mycobacterium species, they can live in dry state also, they resides inside the macrophages, they prevents acidification step also, and this is the reason why the single antibiotics does not penetrate the cell and does not effective, and the chances of relapse are more. So the response of mycobacterial infections towards the chemotherapy is slow, and treatment must be administered for sufficient duration to achieve therapeutic utility. So generally the anti-tubercular treatment lasts from 6 months up to 2 years and even beyond it, depending upon the type of microorganism and the exposure of treatment. So the first major breakthrough was observed as antimicrobial drugs with the sulfanilamide as well as dapsone in the year 1938. But due to the kinetics involved with these drugs are nowadays are not used as far as anti-tubercular treatment is concerned. However, Dapsone is still now used for the leprosy, and it is one of the effective drug as a anti-leprotic agent. Now, major breakthrough was done by a scientist Waksman and his team member in the year 1944, where streptomycin discovered. Friends, it is a first anti-tubercular drug which have a very good bactericidal effect. It can penetrate the bacteria, it goes intracellularly, and it kills the bacteria by its mode of action. However, there are few disadvantages occurs due to this streptomycin, like the drug causes nephrotoxicity as well as ototoxicity, and there is a chances of relapse due to this drug is generally occurs as the treatment advances. And therefore, friends, streptomycin nowadays a little bit less used as compared to the other drugs. Now, finally, the introduction of isoniazid, ethambutol and rifampicin done after the year 1944, and these were the first line agents which are the powerful drug as far as anti-tubercular treatment is concerned. Friends, the choice depends upon the severity of the disease and patient related factors, and therefore these anti-tubercular drugs, they are categorized into two state, first line agents as well as second line agents. So first line agents, these drugs have very good efficacy as well as low toxicity. If we compared these agent with the second line agent, so they are, why they are first line? Because they do not possesses side effect, and if side effects are there, those side effects can be manageable. Now, second line agents, these drugs are reserved for some special cases because of the reason they have low efficacy as well as they have possesses higher toxicity, and the condition is both the second line agents are low efficacy as well as higher toxicity in both the cases of a single drug. So the second line agents, these are the reserved drugs as far as the anti-tubercular drug, anti-tubercular therapy is concerned. Now, heading towards classification of drugs. According to the applicability of tuberculosidal effects, the drugs are classified as first line agents. Those are isoniazid, rifampicin, pyrazinamide, ethambutol and streptomycin. Second line agent drug, they are divided into two form. Oral drugs, these are fluoroquinolones, where levofloxacin, moxifloxacin and gatifloxacin are the drugs, and some other categories like ethiumide, prothiumide, cycloserine, rifabutin, rifampicin are the major one. The another category of the second line agent is injectables, where kanamycin, amikacin and capreomycin are the group. Lastly, friends, some newer anti-tubercular drugs like bedaquiline as well as delaminid also comes into existence. However, the continuous research is still going on over these drugs. Now, the combination therapy of tuberculosis. As we already discussed, that single drug will not effective, because the chances of relapse is more with the Mycobacterium tuberculosis. And therefore, friends, a combination therapy must be required for the anti-tubercular treatment. Therefore, the duration of therapy for a patient with tuberculosis depends upon the severity of the disease, organ affected, and the combination of agents. So there are two phases in the treatment of tuberculosis. First phase is the intensive phase. Now, this phase, which is lasts for 8 weeks, the intensive phase, the treatment is given up to 8 weeks, which makes the patient non-infectious. The second phase is the continuation phase, where the drugs are given up to the 6 months or more, depending upon the severity. And here, friends, at least two drugs should be taken. In the continuation phase, whatever the remaining bacilli are there, they will be out of the body in this phase called as continuation phase. Now, there are four types of drug regimen are currently employed. The first one is directly observed treatment short course, that is DOTS therapy, retreatment regimen, then short course chemotherapy, and lastly long course chemotherapy. So friends, all these regimen, they have a specific drugs along with their doses, with their specific duration is given as per as WHO is concerned. So this is the combination therapy of tuberculosis. Now, prevention of tuberculosis. Vaccination is one of the reason of prevention of tuberculosis by means of Bacillus Calmette-Guerin is given by means of intradermal route. Second is the isolation of patient. Third, wearing mask or cover your face by means of any cloth. Then ventilating room. Maintenance of hygiene is the another way of prevention of tuberculosis. Lastly, strengthen the immune system. Always the bacterial infections are occurred due to the weakened immune system. If the immune system is proper, then no bacterial or viral infection can happen. Now, friends, these are few references which I had taken for this lecture. So, in the next lecture, we are going to discuss about the chemotherapy of different drugs as far as tubercular treatment is concerned. We will discuss there the pharmacology of isoniazid, rifampicin, ethambutol, and many more drugs. So stay tuned, stay connected. Thank you very much. And if you like the video, then do subscribe, support, share, and comment. Thank you very much.